Hello? This movie is the teacher lesson plan resource guide for the video, How Far Are the Stars? Now, this lesson plan is going to have three objectives. First, students will have a short presentation explaining about one of the planets. Second, students will practice using scientific notation. And third, students will create a scale model of one of the planets. This lesson plan is going to require about 4 days of class time. Now, after you've shown the video to your students, have a discussion with them. Ask them, what did you guys think about the video? Did you like it? Did you not like it? Were you surprised by anything? Were there things you already knew? Why didn't Austin ever go to the stars? Check for their understanding and their comprehension. See if there are any parts that they were confused about and try to help clarify for them. Now, after you've shown the video and after you've had the discussion, the next thing you're going to want to do is an activity called the 1,000-yard model. This was created by a man named Guy Ottewell, and it's a wonderful activity for your students. What you're going to do is you're going to make your own scale, and you'll show each of the planets to your students. The class will actually walk among each of the planets. If you look in the lesson plan, it very clearly describes what you're supposed to do, and there's a link there that goes directly to his activity. And again, it's really amazing. Now, understand that the activity does use the imperial system, meaning it's in feet, yards, and those sorts of measurements. If you'd like more of a challenge for your class, you might want to ask them to try to convert everything into metric. On the second day, go ahead and explain about scientific notation. Let the students know, why is scientific notation important? Where could we apply this in the real world? Who uses it? You know, why is it that we can't just use a bunch of zeros all the time? There are a few resources there in the lesson plan. One of the links is called Scale of the Universe. And it's really incredible. It's an animation that shows you starting at Earth, zooming in and the scale of things. And it uses a scale of 10, which is a really nice example to show the students a real-world application. Now the project is going to have a few parts as well. The students, first of all, will be making a planet model to scale. Second, the students are going to need to make an artifact. Now this could mean a written report, or a movie that they create, or a poster. Really, it just needs to be some way for them to show their information. And in this, students should have 4 or 5 important things related to that planet. For example, what is the composition of the planet? How far away is it? What's the size? Really, anything of interest to that planet can be included. Now, in the lesson plan, I've given a few resources as well, websites that you can click on that will bring you to sites that just have a wealth of information related to each of the planets. Now that you're ready to assign the project to each of the students, you can either assign it individually or you can put them into groups. And if you're going to do into groups, I suggest 2 or 3 students per group. For creating the scale model of the planet, you're going to need to help the students conceptualize that if they have something that's a larger size, how to shrink it down to scale. What is the proportion that you've shrunk it? I really encourage you to have the students, along with making their planet, to make something that represents the scale specifically. For example, if I had a scale set of 1 centimeter equaling about 1,000 kilometers, I could say that a penny that is 2 centimeters big would be roughly equivalent to the size of America. And I think that if you do that, it'll really help drive home the point of scale. And the website has a lot of information to help them get started, but be sure to emphasize that they need to be citing their information. If they're doing a written report, where did they get it? You know, they can't simply copy and paste. On the fourth day, you need to give the students an opportunity to present their information. And if you've assigned them into groups, make sure that they're working together and that they've each been assigned specific roles as to who is going to say what. Anyway, I hope that you've enjoyed this lesson plan in the movie, and I hope that it benefits your classroom. Thank you for your time, and thank you for watching Know That.